Hello, this is Bionicle Transformers Synthwave. Synthwave is the first Bionicle Transformer that I designed where I actually started to try. After making Ravenhide, I didn't make any more Bionicle Transformers for a while. Until one day, I really was in the mood for a Shockwave kind of transformer, one with a tank and a gun arm, possibly the gun arm being the tank weapon. I was able to make a cool-looking tank, but this one had a much slimmer profile than I was originally anticipating. The underside has treads, and this piece is, I guess, some kind of slidey thing. I don't know, just ignore that, I guess. You don't have to ignore it. After making this, I was very proud of it. So, the tank gun actually has articulation, but you do have to open these things up. You can go up and down and side to side. You can have it in some stance. You can make a stance where it's pointing up. You just have to adjust these things too. The tank gun does look a little bit wonky, but that's just for the sake of transformation. And I do have his arm stored in the back, which is a bit of an eyesore, but I don't think it really matters all that much. If you really want to, you can angle these arms. This is a rocket, by the way. Can angle out his arms to make it like a tank with a little more extra firepower. This gun shooting here and this rocket thing shooting here as well. That's kind of unintentional, but it is an option if you want. I was planning for it to be a little bit thicker, but I think the slim profile makes it look all the more better. Now, that's all I gotta say about the vehicle mode. Now it is time to transform. And here we have Synthwave in his robot mode, which I am also very happy with. I very much like how the treads end up being his legs, and I like how his feet can fold up to be just a tread like that, and you can just like plop him on the ground with an easy transform. His left arm is a gun or like an arm cannon, which I do very much like, even though it doesn't end up being in the cannon in the vehicle mode. I still think it's a really cool inclusion. And the right arm is just a spike hand. It can be used as a one-time use, incredibly devastating rocket, though, which you can just shoot out and make it explode something. But then he is left without a arm. The vehicle mode doesn't even need any of his arms, but it does make it look a little better. His head is on a ball joint, and this is one of my heads where it's just a glowing armor piece, which I think it looks decent for like a robot head. So, and if you don't have a lot of heads, this is really one of your only options. And moving on to the back, I do really like how his backpack turned out. I like how these armor pieces cohesively connect to these two pieces on this little mini body piece right here. And I do like how I was able to make the cannon just like fold up, which I think looks pretty sleek. Now, I know that at least some of you will want to build this at home. So everything is pretty self-explanatory, except for the backpack, which I'll just remove. And I'm using this small body piece connected to one of these pieces right here. This can be connected to pretty much any bionicle piece if you really do want it to. That's kind of the beauty of this backpack here. Of course, with articulation, he is very articulate. He has a foot swivel, a knee bend. The backpack does block a little bit of backward movement, but that's not really too much of a big deal in my book. This guy can go into a lot of cool stances, and he can even make a pretty nice looking salute, which I thought I'd point out. It's not too important, but hey, it looks pretty good, doesn't it? So, after designing this guy, I decided to call him Synthwave. He's basically a sassy assassin that really likes to snipe people. He is not a scientist, but he does like to reattach his limbs to have other weaponry and stuff. Big fan of weaponry, but not too over the top. I might make an over-the-top weaponry kind of guy in the future, but this guy is just a Decepticon assassin. That's all I gotta say about Synthwave. I will see you next time.